What's the moods, my chicks and dudes? How's the days, thems and theys? Welcome to my face, my channel, and indeed, my 250th episode. That's right, baby. Fresh off my 15th anniversary on the tube, my biggest and boldest foray into official waters, and crucially, my very own TF Wiki page. I now find myself facing the semi-quincent episode of my beloved Transformers review show. And what more fitting way to celebrate this personal and professional milestone than an officially requested product review video. Hooray! Today, we secure the bag with Roboson flagship Optimus Prime.
Greetings.
Wow! I despise it! So I suppose it's kind of redundant to mention at this point how franchise figurehead Optimus Prime has long since transcended the lowly bounds of his home IP in a way that few characters from anything can claim. Optimus Prime is the one true icon of the Transformer world, a robotic dad bod Zeus reigning proudly upon the Olympus of pop culture, standing strong and unshakable, even coming up on his fourth decade on the scene, combining the moralistic gravitas of Superman with the instant cartoon appeal of, say, SpongeBob. So whenever there's an extra franchise you'll a crossover to cash in on, be it a Lego set, a novelty fashion tie-in, a camera for some reason, or even just him wearing another show's away kit, you can bet Optimus is the absolute first draft pick, lending his beplated bonce and window-titted likeness wherever the heat's at. And now, global robotics team Roboson have had a stab at harnessing that uniquely enrapturing power in the form of an all-singing, all-dancing, $1,000 robot. In this economy. Isn't it? This is the world's first licensed robotic Optimus Prime. That is not a toy of a guy who is a robot. This is a robot, boasting an absurd range of automated motion and a stacked action repertoire. With Bluetooth connectivity, his very own smartphone app, and a parts count of over 5,000. And before we even open the box, it's abundantly clear that this is not going for the same audience as my usual fare of like Deluxes and Voyagers, or even the higher end merch like Titans and Masterpieces. This is pitched way higher, swooping onto shelves in this imposing black monolith, adorned with an impressive foil outline and accompanying iconography to assert itself as the biggest big boy collectible for only the biggest of big boy collectors. So yes, big Roptimus Probot requires a touch of setup. Simply slide him out of his smooth black sarcophagus and bang open the handy carry case, which packs plenty of handy equipment slots and a horrible polystyrene shriek. Glide those pesky plastic safety sleeves off, snap on the smokestacks, stand him with plenty of room, like a lot of room. This is not enough room. And let's party. We're partying. So visually, this remote control rockstar serves a clean-ass design that tastefully translates the original Optimus Prime animation model through a Masterpiece-alike filter into a practical and scorchingly modern take that definitely delivers the big boss bot's signature authoritative immediacy and brings in some fan-fave toyetic touches like the yellow wrist arrows and the dummy tummy grill, complete with a cheeky pump-action light-up ion blaster and that hand-mounted Energon axe that I think he used once ever. I mean, it's kind of hard to deny the instant impact of Prime. Presented in such bombastic style at this show-stopping scale, he is decisively here. Effortlessly dominates any space and transforms all by himself. Optimus Prime.
Greetings.
Convert. So I don't need to tell you how impressive that is to witness. Like, it consummately sorts itself out and folds tidily away into a smooth lorry box. It's a wonder to watch him going back to bot mode, rising to a mighty height and unfurling with flair and panache. And it's kind of mind-boggling to watch it balance and distribute its weight on its own shins. But God, it's tricky to film cleanly. Because one way or the other, he's going to end up facing away from you. Tidy that up. But the truck mode is kind of sick, man. It's just a perfect, enormous, ostentatious upscale of that beloved battle convoy cab, which, you know, we joke about, oh, iconic, quote unquote, but It truly is the ultimate machine to turn into a robot, right? There's a reason that it's ingrained in the public consciousness and so dear to all our hearts. It's no accident, and it's glorious. And this massive, oversized, weighty, living robot version definitely packs the clout. It just fills my heart with its Autobot-y opulence. Autopulence. Autobopulence? These chunky wheels and the big square windows. Hefty riveted panels and satisfying truck chonk. Trunk. Brought to breathing life by active idling engine noise and horns and headlights. Turn left.
Optimus Prime.
Oh, it is kind of cool. The truck mode is kind of cool. Have to say, the feet do look a little daft back there, folded up like a coffee table. Look, man, they gotta go somewhere. But yes, aesthetics notwithstanding, the whole Roboson thing is robotics. It's all about automation, so stand back, because it's about to go off! Literally, you gotta give this thing so much room to operate. Keep well clear. Sick. So yeah, if you choose to, you can bark him up into an absolute lather with a ton of pre-programmed voice commands, ranging from awesomely kick-ass cartoon gunfights to borderline inspiring movie-verse moments.
Fate rarely calls upon us in a moment of our choosing.
All the way up to pure cringe Rocky IV birthday cheese. Optimus Prime.
Greetings.
Happy birthday.
Greetings from Cybertron. I am granting you permission to have the greatest birthday the universe has ever seen. Roll out!
Optimus Prime!
Greetings!
Megatron!
Megatron must be stopped no matter the cost.
It's the... Oh, that Megatron! I'll get him. And it is kind of fun to watch him do his thing. Whether he's swinging the rifle around like a mad lad or just doing the silly little Asimo shit your pants waddle run. I guess it is a pretty authentic Optimus Prime experience for the purposes of what it is and what it's trying to achieve. All accompanied by Peter Cullen's velvety voice. But I just can't seem to persuade it to keep doing its thing for more than 2 minutes at a time.
Reboot to restore.
I live in a rented Victorian inner city terrace. I've got a lot of gear, and I'm not allowed to redecorate. So there's a hard limit on how much space I can allow it. It demands so much room, and it hates carpets.
The left hip is stuck. Please ensure the robot is on smooth surface.
I've tried vacuuming. I've tried those little invisible booties that barely stick. I've tried putting a mat down.
The left hip is stuck.
Oh my god!
Please ensure the robot is on smooth surface. Reboot to restore.
It's the smoothest surface in my home.
The left hip is stuck.
It just never seems to be enough. The only place it seemed vaguely comfortable was in my narrow ass galley kitchen.
Get me a beer.
Optimus Prime. Left wheel is stuck.
So in practical terms, unless you've got an enormous laminate floor living room, it's basically no use whatsoever. Like, this is the most consistently it's ever operated, and I'm terrified it's just gonna walk off the edge at any point. It's just the most recklessly frivolous application of technological progress, inconvenienced by having to exist in the physical world. Not to diminish the mechanical accomplishment that it clearly is, but I really can't see a place for it in my life, or in a lot of people's lives. You can barely count to 10 before it locks up and needs rebooting, or just bins it onto the ground and eats shit.
Left hand is stuck. Reboot to restore.
I didn't even ask it to do that pose. Anyway, what bougie-ass 21st century gadget would be complete without its very own accompanying app? That's right, if you get bored of bellowing orders at it, you can simply Bluetooth it up to the app and tap in commands that way.
Connection complete.
This is kinda cool, man. There's like bonus app-exclusive actions and unlockable voice clips to be found among the weirdly dissonant evergreen-styled artwork, along with truck mode touch controls to make it scoot about back and forth. And it's kind of fun to tinker with the robo controls, but it's like there's almost not enough to do, but also the possibility of far too much freedom, because it's essentially programming, and I guess it might be kind of cool if you're into that. It's not my scene, but it seems to be either like very stringent step-by-step instructions to follow to the letter. Touch here, drag this over there, set this number to this very specific quantity. Or it's just total freeform chaos, with literally infinite angles and options and sequences. So I guess you could make it dab or do a Fortnite dance or, you know, pelvic thrust at your mom if you want to, if you got that kind of time. Or you can download some more user-created movesets that the machine itself absolutely cannot handle. So is this where the play value is? Is this a stealth educational programming toy? Like, is this what I'm supposed to get out of it? Because it ain't hitting. And I wouldn't really mind that the Compumatic automations don't really do much for me, but that seems to be the point of it. That's what it does. Like, big RoboFlaps here really ain't much for tactile play, you know, the way I'd normally interact with Transformers. I can't give you the usual spiel today about ratchets and hand feel, because, and I cannot stress this enough, this is not a toy. I mean, it is, kinda, but it's not an action figure as we know them. It is a robot, a cold metal colossus with hands of steel and a microchip mind. You don't play with it in the traditional sense. You're not allowed. In fact, it seems to be affronted by the very notion of being handled. I'm afraid to pick it up in case it wriggles free and smashes on the ground or mashes my finger up in its servos. You gotta download the app. You gotta bark activation phrases at it like a Pokemon. Optimus Prime.
Greetings.
Use Thundershock. And yeah, it is quite good fun for a bit. But like, then what? Stick it on a shelf somewhere? Put it in the display? Can't. It seems unbelievable to me, but RoboSyn flagship Optimus Prime doesn't have a resting robot display mode. It's always like doing life animation and unexpected dabs.
There simply isn't enough time for me to get MP10 into that pose before it'll turn back.
Oh my god. Or you can shut it down into a silly storage squat. Or you can fully power it down and watch it ragdoll in your arms. Oh, no! He died! Optimus! It doesn't seem to want to be displayed. It's too cool for that. It's the kind of thing you put away afterwards. Keep it nice for next time. Pop it carefully back in the box, like a scale extric. And I suppose that gives it an air of like special occasion prestige, but look at it. Visually, it's awesome. I want to display it, but I can't. Can't play with it, can't look at it. So what's the point? Even the box doesn't want you near it. Like, I'm scared to touch it. This matte finish is an absolute thumbprint magnet.
Casual tampering is discouraged.
Get your sticky organic tendrils off it, you messy beast. Well, man, if you're in the position to purchase this thing, I don't think my opinion is gonna sway you either way. Do what you want with your limitless disposable income. But as a Transformers fan and toy collector of moderate means, it just does nothing for me. I don't think it is even for me. Like, is this even a consumer product? Does it need to be available to the public? I mean, I'm sure it'd be great fun at an engineering exhibition. It literally feels like a tech demo styled after something I recognize. I've been to trade shows. I saw a 3D printed Starbug one time when the technology was new. I've been amused by off-brand lightsabers made exclusively of CNC turned parts from a trusted UK supplier. Optimus would fit right in there, posing up a storm and drumming up interest for a plucky, social media savvy components provider. But is it the kind of thing you want to take home with you? All it'll be is a briefly entertaining party piece that'll keep the kids occupied for 6 minutes at a time. And beyond that, it's just another big bloody thing in my house that fulfills no need and costs a month's rent. God, man, I just wish it had let me handle it. I just want to pick it up and have a go. Roll it around a bit and transform it and do some poses. But it's like, ew, no, hands off. Pose myself. Transform myself. Turn my back on you. I feel like it's too good for me. It's not bothered about my company. It won't let me enjoy it. I gotta sit over here and watch it enjoy itself on my behalf. So I don't know, man. This ain't my scene. It looks like it is. But it ain't. I doubt I'd have been interested if they hadn't approached me about doing a review. I absolutely wouldn't have bought it, and I can't relate to the kind of person who would. This is for a class of hobbyist echelons above my income bracket. And it feels like a wildly tasteless thing to try and bring to market during a cost of living crisis. Look at the world this is coming into. I guess if nothing else, it makes the end of the world feel a bit more cyberpunk. Not to be too dramatic, but I look at Robus and Optimus Prime and all I see is death. Like, is this what we're doing? Is this the result of where my life's been headed? Is this what they think I want? Literally $1,000 that'll get you nowhere and it'll never love you back. At least all the other bots in here are sort of inert. I can stomach their indifference. Even Unicron, the toy that set me off on an existential crisis last year. At least that's open to being approached. This is hostile. It's smug aura mocks me. It scorns me. And the feeling is more than f***ing mutual. I detest it. I resent it. I regret taking this review on. And I cannot comprehend how different my life would have to be to accommodate something like this. Robos and Flagship Optimus Prime. The future's here, and it doesn't need you.
Hey, we did it. Thank you so much for watching. Cheers for sticking with me through 250 of these bloody things. Unbelievable. I might not do any more sponsored ones for a bit. I always end up despising the product. So I might just do what I want. How's that sound? But yes, thank you so much to all the patrons who keep me afloat over here. And especially this time. Yes, dab it up, baby, for Studio Henge Kenton. Massively appreciated. I shall see you very soon indeed. And I do hope that you stay sexy. Party on, gang. Laters.
Be sure to subscribe for more Thew's Awesome Transformers reviews. Limited appeal, keeping it real.
Right wheel is stuck. Rebuild to restore. Left wheel is